celebration. Welcome to the choir who is leading us in our celebration. Welcome to each of you here, and welcome to those of you who are watching on Channel 2, and hallelujah, it's working. It's been a morning, let me just say that.
So far, we don't have any sleep.
Today, we are taking a step forward and a step backward, both. We're moving forward beyond some of the restrictions that we've had during the season of COVID for our chapel services. And we're moving back to having our chapel services open to our community. So from here on, chapels, you are welcome to come to our chapel services every Wednesday at 3 o'clock. So this is a very happy day for us. And it does indeed feel like a kind of resurrection. It is appropriate for this day, this week of Easter. We have just a couple of announcements before we move into the program. The choir will be offering this program again tomorrow evening here in the chapel at 7 o'clock p.m., which is another great offering to our community. There is no Bible study this week here in the Villa Life Center, and next week we'll resume our study of the Psalms. The Independent Living Bible Study takes place every morning with Chaplain Jill on Wednesday mornings at 9 a.m. in the Hickory Homes Community Room. And finally, before we go to prayer, we just want you to know that Mullet Place resident Mary Mikulski died yesterday morning. And as we pray, we'll be praying for those who are grieving for her. So let us pray to begin our service. We praise you, O God, who are Creator, Christ, and Holy Spirit. We thank you for the gift of life, the gift of new life, and the gift of resurrected life. And we thank you for the gift of music through which we may offer you our worship. Today, we also thank you for Mary Mikulski and that she is now being held safe by you. We pray for all those who are missing her today, and we ask for your comfort and your peace to surround each one. Now, Almighty God, who through your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, overcame death and opened to us the gate of everlasting life, grant that we who are celebrating the Lord's resurrection with joy may be raised from the death of sin by your life-giving Spirit. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Welcome, everyone. So good to have all of you here. What a wonderfully full chapel. First time in probably 3 years that we've had this many people together. So welcome. It's such a wonderful celebration, especially as we celebrate the resurrection of Christ. So I will be reading a scripture from the first part here, Christ the Creator, that underneath the heading, we celebrate Jesus Christ. So I'll be reading John 1, 1 through 3, and Colossians 1, 15 and 16. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being? And Colossians 1, 15 through 16. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For in him, all things in heaven and on earth were created, things visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or rulers or powers. All things have been created through him and for him.
Thank you.
Thank you.
will be reading scriptures about Christ, the light of the world. From the prophet Isaiah, "The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you." From the Gospel of John, "What has come into being in him was the Word, in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. And Jesus spoke to them, saying, 'I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life.'" From the book of Revelation, "The holy city has no need of sun or moon to shine on it, for the glory of God is its light, and its lamp is the Lamb." In Psalm 27:1, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid?"
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
Christ the Good Shepherd. I'll be reading the King James Version of Psalm 23. Many of you have told me that this was one of the first scriptures you memorized when you were a wee child, and you memorized it in the King James Version. If you remember it or know it in this version, feel free to join me in reading Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen.
Thank you.
just beautiful.
We're going to hear two testimonies to the risen Lord, the risen Christ. The first one from the Gospel of Matthew. After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descending from heaven came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing as white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised, as he said." The second testimony comes from Paul's letter to the Corinthians. In fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have died. For since death came through a human being, the resurrection of the dead has also come through a human being. For as all die in Adam, so all will be made alive in Christ.
Oh, Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. the first thing I'd like you to do, just to see how alert you are, is look at the first page of your program, the outside cover. Take a look at that. This is an amazing cover. It's beautiful just because of the spring flowers that are there. But now I want to see how many of you can find the musical symbols in those flowers. Raise your hand if you find them. Oh, there's several hands up already. What did you find? Treble clef, lower left-hand corner. Has anybody found any notes? The notes are hidden in there. A little bit over to the right and up a little bit are some eighth notes and so on. When you take that home, you can use that for your bedtime entertainment tonight. We'd like to just announce the fact that we are going to give this program tomorrow night, but also at the Kidron Bethel campus on May 24 at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, just like this time, 3 o'clock in the afternoon, May 24. If you have friends in Newton or if you just want to hear it again, you come down. They've got more room than we do. They've got twice as many chairs as we do, so we'd like to fill that up too. May 24, 3 in the afternoon. Now, usually when we sing, we introduce ourselves. Okay, so we're just going to go down the row, and each person is going to, a back row, you stand, and tell us your name and sort of where you're from or something like that.
Sarah Clausen, Beatrice, Nebraska.
Dolores Spanman, and I'm pretty much at home, born in Newton, been living around here all my life.
Mary Regier, we moved here in November from Hillsboro, Kansas.
Linda Miles grew up here in Heston.
I'm Joyce Huber, and I grew up in Eastern Pennsylvania.
I'm Janice Gornett, and I lived in Southeast Kansas until 9 years ago.
I'm Margie McLaughlin. I moved here 1 year ago, Saturday. I came from Newton, lived there all my life.
I'm Sharon Trogg, born and raised in Hutchinson, spent the last 31 years in Mountain Ridge before moving here last year.
I'm Devera Schmidt-Wenger. My mother's name is Emma. My daddy's name is Ernie Schmidt. I was born in Behind the Hustle. I guess that's enough to say.
I'm Lance Skinner, and I lived in South Hutchinson, and I think I came over here to the villa about 25 years ago.
Alva Sommerfeld, and I grew up here in Heston.
Gerald Linebaugh, born in the land of Goshen, Indiana.
Jim Regier, grew up at Bueller, then to Heston, Hillsboro, and back to Heston.
Hutchinson, Bueller, Kansas City, Heston. John Albertson.
Larry Bushman, lived various places, but Hillsboro, Garden City, and Colorado, and then now for 3 years here.
Dan Baumgartner, 64 and a half years in Missouri and 19 and a half years in Kansas.
Rick Weaver, Heston, Kansas.
Warren Petter, born in Henderson, Nebraska.
Wayne Decker, I grew up in Roxbury and started working at Heston Manufacturing in 1958.
Stanley Weens, I grew up in the Gossel community and now live in Heston.
I'm Peter Hartman, I grew up in Elkhart County, Indiana,
have lived in Heston 23 years and 11 years on the campus of Short River.
Leon Jansen, I grew up in the gospel community also.
Agnes Gertson, I was born and raised in Newport, near Newport, Washington State, and moved here, I think 8 years ago, not sure.
Edna Decker, I grew up in Fairview, Oklahoma. I've lived in Heston now 61 years after marrying a Kansas boy.
Evelyn Peters, I grew up at Inman, spent 31 years in Canada working, and now I'm here.
I'm Becky Prepper. I've lived in Newton all my life until 6 years ago when I moved here to Heston.
I'm Liz Miller. I grew up on a farm near Elbing, Kansas. When I married, we lived in many different places, moved back to North Newton in 92, and 8 years ago I moved here.
I am Becky Roth. I moved from Iowa to Heston, Kansas.
I'm Janet Foth. I was born in Newton, but came back to this area when I was married, and we moved over here. We've been here about 4 years, and we moved from across town where we were about 40 years.
I'm Dorothy Zook, and I moved from Harper. Lived here since 68.
Lady Gontrier was born in Cold, North Dakota.
Faith Winger, I was grew up about a block from here on Main Street and have lived in a variety of places including California, Arizona, Indiana, and Japan.
Thank you to our members. If we had time and I was brave enough, I'd go down the row and ask them to tell us how old they are. I think we average around 80 though, but I think they sound more like 60. Don't you?
Let us glorify the Lord with Psalm 96, 4 through 8. For great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. He is to be revered above all gods. For all the gods of the peoples are idols, but the Lord made the heavens. Honor and majesty are before him. Strength and beauty are in his sanctuary. Ascribe to the Lord, O families of the peoples, ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name. Bring an offering and come into his courts.
Thank you.
I did forget to say one thing before during our break, and that is that we've got two full rows here, but we'd like to have three full rows. So if you like to sing, why don't you join us? We practice Wednesday afternoons at 1:30, and we'd love to have you join us. We've got room for more, so please come this Wednesday at 1:30 or talk to one of us, and we'd be glad to welcome you. Well, we're going to practice in the green room. That's below Water's Edge.
Garden
room? Did I say green room? Oh, I'm sorry. I've got these flowers on the front page in my Yeah, Wednesday afternoon at 1:30. We'd love to have you come and join us. You know, as Christians, one of our major activities is to praise God and to glorify Him. We've been trying to do that tonight. We can all find hundreds of Bible verses that tell us to do just that. So it's no wonder that one of the church's most familiar musical expressions is the doxology. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Just checking to see if you knew. Now, there's a traditional tune to that. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. I think we all know that, don't we? But there's another tune to this set of words. And I think some of you in your churches have sung it often. In some churches, it's known as 606, if that means anything to you. So we hope this will inspire you to praise God and give Him glory.
Let there
with his chair later.